It's known as Muppet because it can turn you into one. Also cinnies, legals, the zombie drug. At its worst, synthetic cannabis kills. In New Zealand, unlike anywhere else in the world, that's what it's been doing at an alarming rate. 20 deaths now before the chief coroner. Once legally available in shops, the drug's been driven underground. Its chemistry constantly being modified to avoid detection. It's dirt cheap and everywhere, including, as Janet McIntyre discovered, fielding in the Manawatū, where, a few weeks ago, Rohan Bahram survived a brush with death.
Here's where you were. Now, I started talking to you. I said, Rohan, are you OK? There was no sign that you even knew that I was there. Looking at me, but you weren't looking at me. And then you started foaming.
What were his eyes like?
Well, they were just glaring, just glaring.
It was Rohan Bahram's way of celebrating his 23rd birthday.
Your throat was working, you were dry retching, you were twitching, shaking.
But in front of his father, with a bong in his hand, Rohan almost died.
He took one toke and then just, boom, dropped.
It's all like a movie to me, you know? I just remember having a bong, jumping on the couch and going to sleep.
We saw you lying on the gurney with ambulance, people working on you and putting oxygen masks and sticking monitors all around you. You had two policemen sitting on you because you were thrashing and struggling so much.
Never wanted you to see me in that sort of state.
I don't know, mate. I don't know, mate. I just want to... I just don't want to see that again.
You won't. I was a junkie. I was no different than a junkie. No different at all.
In the town voted 15 times the most beautiful in the country, the streets are neat, the gardens tidy, houses cheap, average price 300,000. Average price for a bag of synthetics, 20 bucks, and maybe your life. Friends Rohan, Summer and Bradley, all in their early 20s, have paid dearly. Throughout the country over the past 4 months, St John ambulance officers were called to more than 800 incidents involving synthetic drugs, and the numbers aren't declining, even after a sudden spike in cases here in Fielding last month. Over a few days, 5 people were hospitalised, another person died.
Behaviour manifests like you've never seen, and it's not right to see. Extremely volatile, unpredictable, violent, threatening, not only towards our staff, but towards bystanders. Yeah, really, really distressing behaviour. And that's probably the hardest thing to manage.
District Operations Manager Steve Yanko has seen it all and knows he'll see it again.
We are literally the ambulance at the bottom of the cliff, and we're here to serve the public, and that includes people that have made bad choices.
What do you think when you see that photo of you comatose?
The worst thing for me is embarrassment. You know, I feel like Superman, you know? Nothing can take me out but kryptonite. And I think I found my kryptonite. Who's keeping it for the daffodils, me or you?
Rohan's mum, Tina, has Huntington's disease.
Try find some flowers to pick, eh?
I first met Tina and husband Don 24 years ago when they'd just learned she'd inherited the Huntington's gene from her father.
Will you have children?
Yeah, I still would like to have children. I have no regrets that I was brought into the world.
Tina now struggles to communicate, but she's aware of her surroundings.
Did you find something, a flower?
Well, a blue daffodil.
A daffodil?
A single daffodil.
A single daffodil. Cool. Do you think you've done her proud?
Have I made her proud? No. Myself, I don't feel like I have. I feel like I could be way better than this.
How much do you care for her?
How much do I care for my mum?
Here they were, 23 years ago, mother and son.
Hell. Yeah, no, I love my mum. Yeah.
But he's tested her in and out of school, jail, and most recently, an ankle bracelet. He's been caught cultivating marijuana, escaping custody, assaulting a police officer.
I've sort of made a mess of things since I was like, well, maybe when I was born. I think I made a mess of things when I was born, yeah.
Now he's trying to straighten up with the support of his parents.
They've just got too much time on their hands because they're not in work. They've been not in education and they've just dropped out of the system and there's nothing for them to do except sit around for the benefit and get high all day.
Since when have you been using weed?
Since I was like 13. 13 would have been about the age that I actually had my first proper session or that, yeah.
And what were you like on weed?
Lazy and hungry. Two words, yeah.
And you were working?
And I was working, yeah.
And what was the problem?
Drug tests. Simple as that. I couldn't pass the drug test.
He lost job after job before turning to synthetics, undetectable on standard drug tests.
And how does it make you feel?
Well, the first initial hit, you feel good. You get like a rush through the body and you feel good. It's just a good feeling.
How long does that last?
5 seconds, you know? And then all of a sudden it's just, you're out, you're asleep, or you're just buzzing, you know? For like half an hour, then it's fully gone. And that's why you're back into another one.
That's it? Just 5, 10 seconds?
Yeah, pretty much. That's the best buzz, is that first initial 5, 10 seconds.
Rohan has witnessed extreme reactions like the ones now routinely recorded on phones all over the world.
A couple of times I've seen people fritter out, seizure, in a way.
Did it worry you ever that, you know, it could trigger such a reaction?
No, not at all. No, I can't, to be honest, I never thought about it.
Until just a few weeks ago, after police, ambulance and the fire brigade were all called out, not once but twice, to help Rohan in the midst of psychosis.
I remember waking up and seeing a cop over me and I felt like I was going to attack him. Didn't want to deal with it, so I just shut my eyes and went back to sleep. And then when I woke up, I was in hospital.
Up next, the boy who gave his all to save his big brother.
What do you think about this drug that killed Bradley?
I actually kind of hate it, yeah, that it's my brother.
And a message from the mob.
Nah, Mongol mob doesn't deal with this stuff. It's got nothing to do with us.
From his older brother Brad, Legion, 14, gets his moves.
Brad, to me, is like a hero. Like, he's like my... a standard that I would want to reach. I would want to, like, follow in the things that he did. Like his fitness stuff, yeah. And like all his dancing.
Brad, who worked as a cook in a rest home, was one of a family of 10 tight-knit kids, including lots of bossy girls.
He's easily persuaded.
Easily led.
He doesn't always make decisions on his own. That's why we used to make a lot of them for him.
And two older brothers, mongrel mob members, Mike and Marcus.
What did he know about synthetic cannabis?
He knew the consequences of using that. I've already put it to him, it's just around the TVNZ sort of thing.
It's been reported the gangs are actually supplying these drugs.
Okay, that's the first I've heard, but I'm fresh out the can, fresh out of jail, so I don't really know about it.
The family says Bradley wasn't addicted to synthetics, but he had two serious run-ins with the drug, first on his 21st birthday last December, when he collapsed outside the family home, and his youngest brother Legion and sister Shai rushed to help.
We had just flipped them over and turned them back, but had found a bag of synthetics under him, and that's when the brother had whacked his back in. It was probably for about 10, 15 minutes he was trying to whack his back in.
I was relieved that he got up. I was like, yes, yeah.
Yeah, you did that.
Yeah.
Even when he come to and we tried to tell him, he doesn't remember smoking it, he doesn't remember falling, doesn't remember ending up in the ambulance. And
he just didn't comprehend how much it affected us and how much it affected him.
Last month, after another session smoking with friends, Bradley again collapsed. An ambulance again was called, but this time he could not be revived.
The heart stops because your body cannot work at that heightened and alert state.
We lost a brother, a real close brother. For 19 years he lived with us, and now we have to continue living without him. It's hard.
What do you think about this drug that killed Bradley?
I actually kind of hate it, yeah, that I did it to my brother. Wish I actually never got into fielding or got into New Zealand at all.
Across town, just a few hours later, Rohan too was in the back of an ambulance fighting for his life.
So did Bradley buy his synthetics from the same dealer as you?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Was it the same batch?
Yeah, it was the same batch.
And so what do you think about that batch now?
I wouldn't call it the bad batch. I'll call it the overly strong batch. You know, it's not regulated no more. People can do what they like with it. You know, people are moaning that it's too weak. Someone ups their ante. You know, you don't know. You're playing with fire. You're messing with fire.
There is another fielding casualty, 22-year-old Summer Willis, a friend of both Bradley and Rohan.
She was my first girlfriend at primary school. She was my first kiss, you know. She was the most beautiful girl you would ever meet. She was astonishing, but synthetics took her away from us. Too early, way too early.
In June, Summer, a solo mum to a four-year-old, was found dead after apparently taking her own life. The cause of her death now being investigated by the coroner.
Synthetics makes you very depressed, very down and out. You feel like everything's getting hold of you without a bomb.
So you know for sure she was using synthetics?
Yeah, she was definitely using it.
How do you know?
Because I used to buy her bags.
Summer's family didn't want to appear on camera, but her mother told me Summer had been using synthetic cannabis for a long time, up to a year. She had many problems. And when her body was found, there was a bag of synthetic cannabis in the room.
Since Bradley Wahanui's death, his oldest brother Mike, a mongrel mob member for more than 10 years, says he and others have taken matters into their own hands.
So you know the person that dealt it to him?
Yep. Yeah, he knows.
And what have you done about that?
He's not here anymore anyway. He's not a problem anymore. He's just moved out of fielding. Yep.
How did that happen?
I think he just got a vibe from the community. You know, everyone knows who's who, and you know, everyone knows these houses. So yeah. It was only a matter of time before he, especially when this uproar happened with the little bro, they know about it.
And how many of these houses are around in fielding?
Not a lot. Then there used to be. There used to be like 15. So there was a few. Yeah.
And how many are there now?
None that I know of.
Police say they've arrested and put before the courts three people in relation to synthetics in fielding. They say they have no direct evidence of a mob cleanup. Scientists are puzzled by the cluster of recent deaths. 20 are before the coroner, an effect rarely seen in other countries. The chemical AB Fubinaca was initially developed by pharmaceutical company Pfizer to mimic the therapeutic effects of cannabis. But it was hijacked by the illicit drug industry in 2014. The powder, constantly being modified, is illegally imported from China, dissolved and sprayed onto plant matter. But other harmful ingredients may also be in the mix.
I am hearing that it's cut with insecticides, petrol, fly spray, horse tranquilizer.
Does it worry you that you've been ingesting that?
Now, after what happened, yeah, it worries me. It worries that you know, that may have been the reason that it was too much, because it was some of this cut stuff or made up stuff, I don't know.
Why would anyone put petrol, insecticide, horse tranquilizers in their body?
It's because people are addicted to it.
And why did Rohan become addicted? He says to ease his pain, growing up watching his mother deteriorate with Huntington's disease, and knowing he has a 50-50 chance he will follow in her footsteps.
It's hard to take in. It's hard to take in. It scares you. No. I just want to escape from reality. It's the way to put it. All anyone wants to do is escape reality, you know? So when I have that stuff, I'm not thinking about if I'm getting Huntington's. I'm not thinking about, you know, where my life's heading or, you know, it's... Everything's gone. Everything's gone.
Gone momentarily.
And then half an hour later comes and it doubles. It just makes it worse, makes it worse, makes it worse. And then you, explode.
Have you now laid down the law with Rohan? I mean, he's living in your house.
Yeah.
This is happening under your roof, in your garage.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we've said no synthetics, you know. It's, that has been a rule since before this happened.
But Don, who's seen Rohan's struggles with addictions over a decade, won't give up on his son.
He has burnt so many bridges that there's no, literally nowhere for him to go. That if I kick him out of the house, then he'll be under a bridge. And I just couldn't handle that.
And he knows that, doesn't he? He knows that you'll never do that to him.
Yeah, I know. Which is probably why he steps over the line.
But maybe Rohan's own close call is enough of a wake-up.
People are actually dying. There are funerals, there are family members missing because of this stuff. But I know every single one knows what they're doing. They know what it does to them. They know that it is affecting not only them and their family members, you know. They say it's hard to get off, and it is hard, don't get me wrong, it is hard. But is your life worth it?
Now, the Institute of Environmental Science and Research, ESR, has told Sunday they've just detected a new substance in a synthetic sample, but they won't yet say what it is. Petrol, insecticide and tranquilizers have not been detected. So how do you think we can stop this plague of synthetics across the country? Let us know your thoughts on our Facebook page.